10 different neighborhoods that have had their slow zones rejected or not yet installed, who have applied from a while ago, are going to be putting up these signs as a demonstration that they want slow zones as soon as possible. This is really an effort to work with the DOT as they try to lower the speed limit citywide and get more people out, get more people involved, and hopefully they'll stay involved and keep pushing for lowering the speed limits and calming traffic in every way they can.
Fort Greene applied for 2 slow zones within our neighborhood, 2 separate slow zones each time, once in 2012 and once in 2013. This was all part of the DOT slow zone application process. Every time any of us pass this intersection in particular, we are reminded that speed and reckless driving deeply affects every single one of us. But our Fort Greene applications for slow zones were not approved. We can still push for these, and we are. Every time you come out to one of these, we are pushing for slow zones. And we can make these happen. Sometimes it takes the people to remind the government that we need to do what is right.
I'm really pleased to see these guys out there doing this. If we're going to lower the speed limit in New York City, we can either do it with the cooperation of Albany or we can go out and do it on our own. And this is some citizen direct action today that needs to be done.
Well, I'm a cyclist. I ride everywhere. And I also live in Fort Greene, and I think it's really important we have safe streets. It's pretty simple. It's not just about cyclists, or it's not just about pedestrians. It's about the city together being invested in actually having safe streets and limiting traffic fatalities.
I mean, it just makes sense. How could you not have a Vision Zero that didn't slow down speeds? This idea occurred to many activists, I think, years ago, and we got so dismayed about the, you know, immovable object that Albany is, and the whole idea that our city streets, the speed of them is determined by Albany.
Beyond slow zones, we are pushing for administration to lower the speed limit across the city. And with Vision Zero, they are ready to, but this takes approval from Albany. And what this means is that the people that can't imagine getting on a subway to go to work, that can't imagine taking the bus to get to their child's school, or can't imagine even just walking down the street to a grocery store, these are the people that are in charge of how our city runs. So we are going to Albany on May 6th. To work to change this, please join us. Save that date. It's a full day. It's a lobby day in Albany, and we need you.